Okay, good morning. I'm sorry it took me forever to get here. If you can hear my cat, I can't help it. She's decided to live in the rafters this morning, and I can't get her out. Can y'all hear her? Good morning, everybody. Good morning. I got a bad hair day going on. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Oh, you're so sweet. You can't hear her, Lord. She's a meow machine. I don't know why we named her Tater. She should have been named Meow. Meow, meow. It's day five, last day, final day. Matter of fact, it's the final day of our challenge. We're going to wrap up the 2021 Self-Mastery Challenge this morning. And, well, technically, we're going to wrap it up in the morning, tomorrow morning, Saturday morning. And that's exactly where I'm going with this morning's lesson. And I hope this has been a really fun week. This has been a really great week for me. I've lost weight this week. I have stayed the course. I have struggled a couple of days, including yesterday. Yesterday was a struggle. I was sore from tiling the day before yesterday. And I tell you what, I'm too young to feel this old. So as I feel older and older, I tend to want to eat. And this is, I know it sounds terrible, but the truth, it's my mental justification for not wanting to get up and move around is feel sorry for myself. I always feel better when I get up and move around. Can any of you guys relate to what I'm saying? The more I actually get off my tail and move around when I'm sore from moving around, the less I ache from being sore. It's really not being sore. I think I ache from laying around. There's probably some technical explanation for it that's better than my pondering. However, it is true. It is a simple diagnosis that I can, a self-diagnosis that I can do that's accurate. I can do a hypothesis and test it. The scientific theory, hypothesize and check your hypothesis to see if it's correct. I wore my official self-mastery challenge shirt from last year to commemorate this last and final roundup for 2021. Good morning, Amy. Good morning, Angela. Good morning, April. Good morning, Christy. Good morning, Buckus. Good morning, Cindy. Good morning, Diane. Good morning, Jeanette. Good morning, Jen's with us. Good morning, Anda. Good morning, Julie. Good morning, Michelle. Good morning, Nathan. Good morning, Nina. Onesia, good morning to you. Good morning, Patricia. I'm glad you guys made it. I'm glad we all have made it to this day. Although it is a sad day because the challenge will end today, it is a great day because we made it to Friday. Hopefully you have made it to this day with four perfect days in a row before it. I know a lot of us are not here this morning because I have several names that I'm getting worksheets from every single day. Right? Good morning, Janine. Every single day I've been getting worksheets from participants that are, you know, the majority of our great job, Amy. The great job, the great majority of, excuse me, the worksheets that I've been getting are positive. And I, with the exception of cooking holiday treats, cookies and candies, because there's been a couple of people that have just put themselves through the ringer because it's that season, I assume. I've not done that. I've not cooked any treats, but I have pretty much struggled in the same ways as ever. I have struggled to get steps in a few days. I have struggled with not wanting to do it. just having to make myself do it. But alas, I have got up and got in the steps, or got up and got the things done when I was struggling, pushed through, persevered, however you want to say it. I have called my sponsor every day this week, and I have told him about myself, what I've been doing this week. That's my worksheet for this week, is I have been being accountable with my feelings and my comings and goings with another person in an inventory-like fashion. He was happy to hear from me, I'm sure, but he was also, he did the same thing with me that I've done with you guys. Just been a part of my life, right? And a lot of the times, that's what we need, is a brother or a sister or a friend to stick close to us and just acknowledge that, what, Nathan, that we have been on this road together, that I'm not alone doing this. The Bible says, woe unto him who falleth down and no one is there to help him up, right? That's what the Bible says, and that's a terrible quote of what it says, but it's true. It's tough when we do things alone and we fall down. Now, there's some good Star Wars wisdom in that thread of thinking, but I'm not going down that road. I will tell you that failure is the greatest teacher, and that is a Star Wars quote, but it was a quote long before Star Wars was a thing. Before I actually get into the lesson this morning, I just wanted to definitely make sure everybody knows how thankful I am for you, how blessed I am to know you, and how much I have enjoyed you letting me be in a small part of your Shibboleth journey, not just this week, but if I've been a part of your journey for any part of your journey, I really appreciate it. I'm positive that you guys have helped me much more than I've helped you. And if you don't know how that works, one day you will. All right, it's time for our lesson. Are you ready? Are you guys ready? First, I do that a lot, don't I? Sorry. Before I get into our lesson, let me remind everybody who's doing this for the very first week. You've got to wake up in the morning and do it one more time. What do I have to do in the morning? I have to get on the scale, weigh, and then complete your challenge. Is there anybody in my group today that doesn't know how to complete the challenge? There's two ways to do it. You can either go to the challenge section where you sign up for the challenges, the group challenges, and click on complete. There'll be a little button where it says, well, it shouldn't say anything now, but it would say complete there and finish. Or you can go to the challenge portion of your journal. There's a little section in your journal, your online journal, and it will say, have the same little button that says complete. You'll need your weight. And I'm almost certain I set this challenge up to require a front and side facing picture to complete your challenge. Okay. Let's earn our badges in the morning and let's finish strong together. Now I'm ready. Good morning, Nellie. Good morning. I was a little bit behind as well. All right, let's get the lesson underway. And I think it's a good finishing note. Hopefully you will too. Hopefully it's not too loud. Here we go.
It's just like Beggar's Canyon back home.
Use the force to let go.
strong.
Okay, so that was loud, but it was great. It's like the condensed version of the last 10 or 15 minutes of that little ending fight scene, Star Wars New Hope. You don't, if you never watched it, Cindy Gwynn, it was filmed in 1977. So although it's awesome to me, you may look at it and see Buck Rogers, you may not know what Buck Rogers is. Anyway. That was the very, very short version of a whole bunch of really good stuff. But I want to focus on Obi-Wan. My Obi-Wan was my favorite character as a child, not Luke Skywalker. Okay. It was not Luke Skywalker. It was not R2-D2 or C-3PO. It was Obi-Wan Kenobi. Not Yoda. I know I've got some friends that do Yoda quotes with me and all this stuff, and they talk like Yoda, and we do that. It's that, listen, Obi-Wan Kenobi is the guy. He was my guy. And this is the best, this last quote for the challenge. I want to really hope this goes home with you. It really goes home with me, especially watching that clip again. I watched it twice this morning. It's the perfect clip to end our challenge. If you don't know what's going on, Luke, the guy that's in the spaceship getting chased from the beginning is us. Luke is us. He's the hero that doesn't know he's the hero. He's the participant that doesn't really fully understand that everything he needs to be successful is in his heart, and it's in the universe, and it's supplied by the Almighty. And he has a mentor, and he has, which is Obi-Wan, who is speaking to him in the movie, literally. Right, he's hearing audible voices in the movie. I'm not going there with everybody, but stay with me for a minute. Obi-Wan Kenobi, Luke's trainer, mentor, is telling him to use the Force. Use the Force. If I can say this to you, Cindy, use the Force, Cindy. Let go. Whenever you feel like I've got to dial this in a little bit. Is there some more technology I can have? Is there another app I need? Can I learn a little bit more about this aspect or that aspect? Do I need to work out harder? Do I need to add more of this? Do I need to take away more of that? Jesus is over here whispering in our ear. He's our mentor. He is our Obi-Wan Kenobi that's connecting us to God, right? To God Almighty himself. Jesus is saying, hey, Jen, let go. Let go. Use the Force, Jen. Let go. Okay? That's what he's saying. Onesia, use the Force, Onesia. Let go. Okay? That's it. Tiani, let go. That's how, Patricia, use the force, Patricia, let go. Let me go over here and read you some Bible, because some of you are thinking, Lord, he's done gone crazy. He's giving us Star Wars quotes. and we're having a real hard time. Okay, look here. This is not I hope everybody remembers this. I'm not trying to tell anybody that they're not doing this. Okay? We all do this, but we all are Luke. We all have this amazing, wonderful Holy Ghost power. That if we have Jesus, we have salvation. We have all of that stuff. We claim it. We believe it. Wouldn't take that away from anybody, okay? But when we get into the trench, like Luke, right? When we get in the trench and we're flying and we are on a mission, we've got the enemy after us. They're locked in on us. The enemy locks in on us. He's trying to defeat us. He is firing at us. He's hitting us, right? We are facing adversity. There's gun turrets to our left and right firing at us as we go through. But we have a goal. We have everything it takes to make it. What we do in that time is we stop listening and we stop focusing on, right, the force. And we start to dial in our technologies and our personal efforts. In other words, we white knuckle. I mean, y'all, somebody better amen me right here. I can feel this, right? I can feel this. The closer we get to the target, the closer we get in the battle to where we're almost there. Instead of letting go and using the force, we apply the most liberal dose of ourselves as we can. We put more and more and more and more of ourselves on it. Why do you think I preach every day? Why do you think I try to remind you that Jesus is really all the power we need? Okay? What y'all didn't know, while you were focusing on this, that, and the other, your pants have been getting loose, right? The scale didn't go down this. We've had a couple testify already this week to getting measurements, right? And the measurements blew them away, even though the scale didn't, the measurements did. Other people will see what we don't see because we're not focusing on the exact right thing at the exact right time. Let's go to Romans chapter 13. Start on chapter 13. Chapter 13, verse 1. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers. Right? Listen, y'all. This is important. Importante. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers. For there is no power but of God. There's the force. There it is. Romans 13, chapter 1. I'm sorry, chapter 13, verse 1. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers, for there's no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God, and they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. Whew. I'm glad I didn't write that to us. Huh? Glad I didn't write that to us. Remember sometime this month, this week, I said something about Saul. Why did thou persecute me? Who is that that speaks to me, Lord? It is I, Jesus Christ, who thou persecutest. Remember? We went over that. Listen to this. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers. There's no power but of God. And if we don't stay subject, what happens? 13, 1 and 2. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God, and they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. Let's not do that. Let me just say, I'm starting with that verse so I can end on a much, much more positive verse. This is the reminder. This is Obi-Wan training, not Obi-Wan final moments. Obi-Wan training, Romans 13, 1 and 2. Now, Let me explain this. Why do I need to be subject to God? Why do I need to be God's subject? Let's go to another place. Let's go to Ephesians. I love this verse. One of my favorite verses in the whole book of books. Ephesians chapter 3. I'm not going to read it all. I'm going to go directly to my favorite verse. 20. Ephesians 3, 20. Okay. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. Did you know that God can do much, much more than we can think or ask? That's why we got to be subject to it. Because it doesn't matter how much we know, how much we want, how hard we thought about it, how educated we are about it. God is more powerful than that. He's already thought about it and way more than it for us. That's why we need his power, not him to make our power better. We need his power. We need to what? Stop using ourselves and what? Use his power. Use the force. Use the force, Chris. Let go. Be subject unto the higher power. Why? Because he is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. That's it. According to the power that worketh in us. What power is that? The higher power. Which one? The one that we're subject to. That's rich. It's rich. Are you following with me? Are you following with me? We got this is my message for today. Just stay with me. I'm almost done. This is a good one and it's short. That may be why it's good. 2 Timothy chapter 4. 2 Timothy chapter 4. Let's go down just a little bit. We need to fight the good fight to the end. Just like Luke getting in that trench. Paul in 2 Timothy is writing to Timothy. Listen to how he words this. I have fought a good fight and I have finished my course. And I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness with the Lord. The righteous judge shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. That is our mandate from henceforth, I hope, is to finish well, right? To finish well enough when the Death Star blows up behind us, right? When the Death Star blows up behind us and we're getting out of there and everybody's celebrating. This is our celebration verse. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. I fought the good fight. I fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. All right. And I'll be really short today. Romans chapter 12. Down there towards the bottom of Romans chapter 12. Remember, this is my Star Wars theme ending note, okay? Romans chapter 12, verse 21. Be not overcome of evil, but overcome evil with good, right? Use the force, but use it for good. Use it for good. You've got everything it takes. You're 100%, 1,000% equipped. There's such thing as 1,000%. You are 1,000% equipped. Let's say 0 to 100% equipped is what you can do of yourself by yourself. 1,000% is what 100% plus the power of God can be. Okay. You're 1,000% equipped to finish the course well. Okay. I know some of y'all are like, thank God Star Wars is over. I have loved this week. I hope I've been a blessing to somebody this week. I know that you have been a blessing to me. Thank you for participating with me and meet me here every morning. And I love you guys, and I hope y'all have a wonderful day.